You know, I don't feel like target practice right now. I'm wondering what's going on upstairs.
Yeah.
Just to go check out what's upstairs.
Let's go check out.
Let's just,
What?
Oh, what? What? What's happening? I was not expecting this, Kojima.
This game is fucking retarded.
What? This is crazy. I was just gonna shoot some targets.
I didn't expect this.
Oh, shit. What?
No!
No way. He's here.
Wait a minute, what?
Why is he shooting at us? What? How did he get a gun? Yes, finally. Never again.
My work is done.
You didn't do anything.
About V for victory. Rocket, peace.
He's gonna shoot rockets at us. What? Oh my god, that's where it came from.
Holy shit. I saw that in Metal Gear Solid 5. That's
yeah, you can shoot your hand in Metal Gear Solid 5.
Yes, but that was insane what he just did. That looks like a power glove from the Nintendo power glove. This mission is garbage.
Kaz, I found Zadordar. I had to kill him.
Yes.
So much for our fugitive.
Why do we keep
Something's
him alive?
Not right here. I'm thinking he had a friend.
Someone inside MSF.
He had a Tomodachi?
It's Zeke. It's moving.
What?
There's
oh no.
Inside. I can see them.
Oh fuck.
Snake, get up here.
Oh no. What's happening with Zeke now? Oh no. What?
Pick Zeke. Up the hand, you fool.
Yeah. The hand alive still?
I guess so.
No. It's dead. Oh no. So what's happening now? Our peaceful target practice was interrupted.
Does that mean we have to fight a Metal Gear?
Oh,
who
God,
would have
no.
thought?
Is Huey evil? Because he did build Zeke. What a bastard he is. Oh, God.
Oh, shucks.
Oh, God. What could this be? Oh, no. Oh, no. It's Zeke. And it's got my paint job. And it's got my railgun. And it doesn't have my armor. Thank God. Thank God it doesn't have armor or the...
Yeah, if we gimp it. Wait, was that Pat?
Boss.
You cunt.
Get down from there before you hurt somebody.
What?
Maybe
bitch.
I want to hurt somebody.
What's going on? She's not herself.
Oh, I am myself all
Why right. is she in panties?
My true self.
Oh my god. Metal
what?
Gear, Metal Gear Pat.
What the fuck just happened? This game got interesting again.
Oh my god.
Kaz, shut that thing down.
I can't! The controls aren't responding!
Then how's it moving?
I made some modifications. This
what?
Machine was meant to have a human pilot.
Uh-huh.
Modifications. Kaz, what are you-
Never thought I'd be into machines, huh?
Then Zadornov's escape was a diversion.
Kaz,
oh no.
What are you doing?
I'm taking it back.
Taking it back? Where?
To our leaders. To Cypher.
Cypher?
Cypher? What the... What? Whoa.
Wow.
What?
This weapon is Cypher's creation.
What the... F-
Pops! Get down from there!
Do not call me that. I am Pacifica Ocean.
What the fuck is happening in this
took a
story?
This took the most... This took a 360, 180.
Who the fuck is Cypher and why is she the Pacific Ocean?
Them all to
my
me.
Gender.
My entire life has but one purpose. To carry out Cypher's plan.
Bitch.
The nasty tobacco. The angel of peace crap. The whole team with a dream routine. I am proof of all
dream.
Of it.
Pause. You can't.
I told him not to call me that. It makes me want to puke.
Bleh.
Everything is going exactly as planned. Now the real Peace Walker project is finally about to reach its goal.
Real project.
Oh no. There's a hidden agenda behind everything. Oh no. Oh no, revelation.
I didn't expect pause.
You know what? I did.
Once upon a time.
Kind of.
There were two young men who idolized a hero called the Boss. One
oh, no.
day, they suddenly lost the point of origin. This Cypher, that was like a mother to them. Unable to come to terms with their sorrow, They each decided
oh my God.
Oh shit.
But they could not agree on what that meant. In the end, they became bitter enemies, and the zero from which they both started was split into two.
Is Cypher Zero?
Yes.
And you have been on the wrong path ever since. There is no happily ever after waiting for you in the end, unless you obey the will of Cypher. Where does an army without borders call home? A state without borders, of course. A world without borders.
A world without borders.
The Cold War order is about to collapse. The age of electronic intelligence is about to begin.
Oh my God.
The NSA, CSS, NRO, DIA, etc.
Oh my God, she's saying
the intelligence
things.
Community that is long bickered amongst itself will be united in a world governed by electrons. Cypher will gather all information, watching over the world and guiding the will of its people, all while they remain blissfully unaware. There will be no one to oppose them. For the first time, the world will be ruled by a single will. Until the new order is in place, you and your army will be the force that protects it. You will be Cypher's deterrent, pulling the wool over the eyes of the old order with your charisma and military prowess. Accept our offer, and we will allow you to retain control of MSF and Zeke.
That's an offer.
Dialogue choice.
The boss threw down her gun, and with it, her life's call. You, her disciple, have never been able to do that. You are too afraid to let go.
I was made to fight. I am a gun.
Is that so? Then what do you call this? Is it a gun too? You are a lousy liar. Admit it. This thing is a monstrosity. A product of your own fear. But not Cypher. Cypher thought of something different. Cypher is going to control guns.
Nanomachines.
Oh my God, he's going. This is Metal Gear Solid 4.
Control. It is the ultimate approach to the illusion of peace.
Control power. You're gonna be disappointed.
Control.
Then we are done. Thank you for playing. Better luck next time.
No, game over.
Is rescinded. And now the ultimatum. Zeke is already in nuclear strike mode.
What?
I'm taking the weapon you built and using it to launch a nuclear strike on the east coast of the United States.
You're insane. What are you after?
But wait. Here is your consolation prize. We are about to show the world just how dangerous a gang of outlaws, an army without borders, can be. You and your men will become pariahs,
what?
And you will be wiped off the face of the earth. Rather than heroes, you will be seen as a well-armed extremist cult prone to indiscriminate outbursts of nuclear aggression. You will give rise to a new world order, an age of deterrence defined by a sphere of extremist cult influence. Do you like the picture I am painting? Big boss. When all is said and done, peace is nothing but a fantasy. A game is a game. You either win or you lose. All you can do is fight. Stop me if you can.
What's happening with the water?
The peace sign is the V of victory. Say, peace.
What? I don't know what the... What?
This game took like a 720.
Is she going fucking Evangelion and that's LCL?
No.
Is that Fooly Cooly inside the entry plug?
No.
Is that what's happening here?
What is fucking
happening? Oh my God. Is the soul of the boss inside Metal Gear Z?
Oh my God.
Oh my God. Is Snake's father gonna do something?
What?
What? Oh.
Boss fight.
He's gonna launch a nuke.
Are we just fighting the...
Yeah, oh my God.
Already? Like, I thought that was a mission.
Oh.
Oh, that does make sense. Okay. Okay, then. So, it was all for this. And that was completely insane.
That was.
I saw something in Ground Zeroes that made me think something's gonna happen with Paz. I don't know what Paz... I don't know what we... I know something else is gonna happen.
Yeah.
With someone else. I don't want to say yet, but...
Because we already played Ground Zeroes.
So yeah, we
kind of spoiled it for ourselves.
We played Ground Zeroes. I didn't know what the fuck was going on when I played, because I hadn't played Peace Walker. I was like, who are these people that I don't recognize?
Yeah.
Oh my god. Oh my god, the music. Do you have the crazy music?
Hold on, I'm loading.
It's so tactical. Oh my god. But this should not have required
this
so much.
This is five skulls.
So much ridiculousness to fucking unlock. Oh my god, guys. So many hours. So many. Fuck. Alright, we're gonna. Alright, okay. This is, we're finally here.
We're at the end.
We finally reached the final thing. And we've just gone over an hour in the recording, so we have to cut it here, so hang on. Okay, guys, we are back.
Hour number 8.
I feel like my throat is sore.
Let's go, let's destroy Paz. Let's fucking, oh my gosh,
we played
destroyed.
We played 4 hours of Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker yesterday. And we played, this is our 8th hour today. We usually record 2 hours, like, a week.
Yeah.
This is our 8th hour today. Our 12th hour in 2 days. This is insane. Yeah. The only reason we're doing this is because stupid Metal Gear Solid 5 comes out so fucking soon.
Yeah, the release date got pushed earlier than before. It was supposed to come out, like, the 15th or whatever.
And so that means I have... Oh my god, I've got 13 hours of video to edit. I have 13 hours of video to edit. That's 26 episodes. Well, I'm going to cut a lot of it out, a lot of the last 4 hours out, but I just uploaded part 17, and I have 26 episodes.
Holy shit.
26 episodes worth of content to edit and work through. I will not... live.
You could just do a monologue, just like, yeah, we fucking played.
I should just do like a, just put it all in one timeline and just mash it all together. Just the quickest fucking play speed. It's just like chipmunks fucking, I don't know. Paz is an evil chipmunk.
Oh, we got a song.
Sung by Paz. She's singing a song.
Go fuck yourself, Paz.
She doesn't sound... Oh my god, it jumped over my fucking rocket. It literally jumped over my rockets.
Oh my god. What the fuck?
Don't do that. Don't. That's mean, Pat.
Dude, can you stop dodging, please?
Okay, so I'm going to be honest. What I was expecting was going to happen was I was expecting... A Metal Gear, the Metal Gear Peace Walker was alive again, and we have to fight it with the Zeke. That's exactly what I thought was gonna happen.
That would have been ridiculous.
That's what I wanted and expected. I expected Paz to be like captured or something. What is this? I can interact with this. I don't know what this is. Oh my god! Transport catapult?
What?
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 What the fuck? What are we doing? What is this?
I don't know, man. Interact with
this thing. I can interact with this thing, too. Strike request?
Oh, my God.
Up against the wall.
I'm running.
Up against the wall. This music rules, and it's ridiculous. Oh, my God. We have to target
that. Bombs away, boys!
Dude, this rules!
Fucking
this is awesome! This boss fight fucking rules!
Oh, it's down!
And this music is ridiculous!
I know! Alright, supply marker, let's go!
It has to reload! I shot it in the Zeke crotch, I tried to. Look at its HP!
It has so much!
This is insanity!
Alright, catapults, let's go!
Alright, which one are... Alright, you go for that one, I'll go for this one over here. No, don't reload, you fool! Oh my god! Okay, this boss fight almost kind of made that worth it. Almost. This is pretty...
Is that of ammo? Oh, fuck. Oh, ready to launch!
Get up against it. I'm gonna target it. Get him!
Fuck you! It dodged it!
What? What happened there?
You dodged it.
Did it?
I think so. just jumped! I saw the missiles fly past it, I think.
Bullshit! Paz, you... why are you being so mean?
Shut up, Paz.
Oh my god, it just shot me with its railgun.
Ow. You do not have much HP.
I have courage.
Yeah, okay.
Kids are getting hungry. Dude, these little machines cannot be destroyed. I just shot it with the railgun like twice. Alright, activate the thing. No, don't reload, stupid. Why does it have to be the same button?
Yeah.
No.
Oh my god!
Dude. This music is ridiculous, but I kind of like how insanely weird it is.
It just adds... it adds to everything we just experienced this past day. This is the culmination of today.
Oh my god.
They're stepping on the stuff!
Bitch. It's not even half dead.
No, it's not.
Fucking amount of things.
We get strike.
I'm out of law. The law has died.
Fucking get destroyed. Oh my god. I missed, kinda.
Oh my god.
Oh my god.
Not the M60. I just want her to jump one more where is she?
Okay.
Go! Fucking bitch!
Whoa, buddy! What really? Are you doing, buddy?
Oh my god, dude! Perfect! No, not really, but almost.
I'm chaffing it up!
I'm supplying it up. I'll throw another chaff. Oh fuck, right. That's why my supply marker wasn't working. Makes sense. Reload, 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 reload.
Oh god, it's shooting me.
Supply marker.
Ow! It hurts!
Alright, interact with the things!
I am!
I'm going to mine.
Let's go! Oh my god! Just get it annihilated!
Oh my god! Oh wait, are they both the same thing?
I don't know!
Transport catapult?
Oh, it's sending us supply drops!
Is that what it's doing?
Yeah!
Oh shit!
That's awesome! Fucking awesome! Yeah, there's a bunch of supplies over here. Oh my god.
Jesus.
Oh my god.
Get away from me.
Shut up, boss.
Oh god. I'm like fucking just blocking all of her fucking shots. Oh god.
Let's go!
I'm going for it.
Fuck.
No, I don't think mine's ready.
No. Yours is the catapult.
Oh god.
Ow! Oh my god, I almost fell off. I don't know if I can fall off. That's scary.
Let's not let that happen. Oh, Jesus!
What is this timer?
I don't know, but it... oh my god! There's a fucking... the nuke!
What? Oh, no, never mind.
Oh my god, what was that?
Oh, okay!
Oh!
It's the missiles, I didn't get it... I didn't target it.
What's this transport catapult? Is that...
yeah, it just dropped stuff for you!
Oh. Okay.
Okay, this thing is straight up
targeted or something. Target something. Jesus Christ! That wasted a whole curry. That was an entire meal's worth of pain.
There's so much ammo here! There's so much! Oh shit! Oh god!
What was that? What just happened? What's going on?
It's hurting me! Strike marker! Yes!
Oh. Yes!
That was amazing! Now it's time for my strike marker that I placed 10 years ago! Oh, yes!
Almost dead! Bitch!
Fuck you!
You lying bitch! Oh my god. It really hurts.
Uh oh. Oh god, I didn't run so far!
Strike marker, strike marker, strike marker, strike marker! Where did it jump?
Oh, jump. Two bars! It's so cool!
Strike it! Strike its face! No! It dodged it. No, it did. Oh, I didn't. Okay, I didn't use it yet. I'm stupid. I'm out of gusto. I'm going to your missile thing.
Ah, I fucked up. No! No! You can only use it when she's on when it's on that side of the map.
Die!
Oh my god, it's so close! Just unload everything!
This is insane! This is the greatest boss fight!
Oh my god! What the fuck?
Bitch! You will die!
I have ammo!
My final law!
I have 5 more! Let's go! There's more law over here!
I blew up this... Where is it, law ammo?
No! Not the cannon! I'm missing!
M60!
Die! I'm missing! There we go.
Shoot it!
We did it! Oh my god!
That was ridiculous!
Fucking boss fight!
Why did they make this amazing boss fight so hard to get to? This rules! I want another part to that boss fight. I want more. I hope that wasn't it. I want more. That was it, that's fine, but I want more. Paz was a bitch the whole time. I can't believe that shit. Oh my god.
Zeke is out of my control.
Look at her face.
This is where it ends. Listen
to
me.
Underwater.
Big boss. As long as your army is needed, the world will never know true peace.
Solidus.
The peace you know will be plenty. Illusory. They will use you, disgrace you, and then finally discard you like they were a cancer to society.
Oh man. She's talking about.
She's talking about Metal Gear Solid 1 and Metal Gear 1. All those games. Mean.
That was madness.
Wow.
That was complete.
Wow.
Madness. Oh my god, it's Kaz for the first time. Forever.
I know.
He looks cool with his scarf thing.
Mine, like, has already ended. What the hell?
Well, it's because you weren't Snake. You don't get the super secret.
No, my God.
Where he says.
We have to beat
where
it
he looks.
Wait, what?
Where he looks wistful.
Where's all the cutscenes?
I know. I don't like that I'm seeing this screen. This needs to go away.
Hey, we got a.
Who would have thought that little fuck.
Shit.
Working against us?
Tell me about it. She had everybody fooled, me included. Can't believe I didn't pick up on anything.
Snake, there's no point in beating yourself up over the past. But hey, Maybe you should put in some practice against Zeke in case this sort of thing ever happens again. In any case, I need to go talk to Dr. Strange.
Yeah.
Zeke still isn't ready.
Huey.
Zeke still isn't ready. What does that mean? Ready for what?
I'm fucking not.
Ready
is there
for
like a tenth?
What, Huey?
Is there like more missions?
Is Huey the final boss?
Oh my god. What's
super, the super special? Oh my god, Dr. Strangelove looks very suspicious. Oh my god, Huey.
How's it going? How's Zeke look?
With his walking
the
wheelchair.
The control AI had a backup, so it should be able to walk.
Really? That's good.
Aww.
Beyond that, it's up to the creator. Stop! Don't come any closer, Doctor.
There's something I've been meaning to ask you. Do you...
Really?
Do you despise me?
Doctor, are you asking me out?
No, what? No. Not at all.
No. Pity. Because I've just had my heart broken by someone else.
What?
I only like those who can stand on their own.
Ugh.
If you fancy me, then come walk with
me.
Who knows what miracles might happen. Love is blind after all.
This...
Take your time. I'll be waiting.
Wow, so that's Otacon's mom.
What I want to know is who is Otacon's stepmom. Because he bangs her in Metal Gear Solid 2.
Wow. Okay.
What the heck? Ultra high res.
Yeah,
helicopter
what?
There. Oh no, it was just a normal. Okay. Kind of fucked up though, if you really think about it. Like she was just saying,
Snake.
Well, if you could walk, then I could go out with you.
I think it's just like a metaphor type of thing.
I think she was making fun of his handicaps, or
don't know, man.
I think she's shitting on people in wheelchairs. I think
know,
that's
man.
What she's doing. I think this friggin' limey lesbo.
Oh my god! What the fuck?
And then I'm only saying that because she's hating on the
handicap.
Oh,
what the? What? Alright, freaking...
That's why I'm saying that, YouTube. So...
Dude, it's got...
I'm totally
you just,
justified.
You took
that
this guy's hand
mentioned at the end
for a lighter.
Cipher. It's a code. It means empty. It also means...
A cipher...
A world of electronic intelligence built on codes. And at the center of it all, a zero. Cause... Look, boss. I owe you an apology.
What?
Hear me out, okay?
Sure. Buddies forever.
Bestest
friends.
Knew Potts and the professor. I knew who they really were all along. Cause I used them.
What the fuck?
I suppose you were the one that brought them to Columbia in the first place, huh? Guilty as charged. Potts wasn't just CIA, you know. She was working for the KGB
too. She was CIA?
And for this cipher.
I remember that.
What the fuck?
In other words. She was a triple agent.
You knew all of this.
Wait,
triple
let me finish.
Agent.
Listen, MSF never would have gotten this big if it weren't for them. This mercenary business we've built. Someday it's going to be a new driving force in the world economy.
Is that your goal all along?
PMCs.
The Cold War is not going to last forever. Sooner or later, it's going to give way to an era of regional conflicts and terrorism. A paradigm shift from counter-communism to counter-terrorism. In the new age, armies won't be tied to states, and war will become a business. We'll be a valuable commodity. There'll be clients all over the world who need our services. MSF is only the beginning. What we're creating here is a revolution in itself. Am I right?
Cause... It's not going to be that easy.
What do you mean?
This whole Peace Walker thing has left our mark on the history of the old order. We've put ourselves on the radar of intelligence agencies and governments east and west. The whole world probably knows about us now.
Including that cipher outfit.
We've let ourselves interfere with the times. Cold War system of deterrence. We're an army without a flag. We weren't supposed to take sides in international affairs, but we did.
I see your point. So what happens to us now?
We'll be hunted.
Not everybody's gonna be happy with us, huh?
You're damn right. We upset the global military balance of power.
And these people would rather our army without borders not exist at all?
They're gonna come knocking real soon. There's no turning back now. We are a wrench in the old system of deterrence. As long as the times refuse to change, we're gonna make a hell of a racket.
Then who are we gonna fight?
The establishment. Anybody who tries to restore the old balance wants to snuff us out of existence.
Which establishment?
It won't be a particular country or ideology that hunts us.
Who then?
We are gonna be fighting the biggest beast of all. The Times.
What
10 years ago, the Times rejected the boss and killed her. And now, we're the ones being tested. Will the Times erase us? Or work with us? It's gonna be a lonely battle. No good or evil. No winners or losers. Business will have to wait. The question we have to ask ourselves now is, can we survive long enough to see the 21st century?
I'm with you, boss. We'll see how it turns out together.
Damn.
What did you do, Cass?
Badass.
What did you do, Cass?
Cass wanted to build the army without borders.
You fiend.
How did he know, though?
Because he's Cass.
Because he's Master Miller. Because
he's the master.
What?
Oh, my God. There's a number of... Okay, I think this is the same.
Yeah.
Japan... Nicaragua sounds that it takes hostages, blah, blah, blah. Former president of Costa Rica, Jose,
yep.
For that. Ho Chi Minh campaign, North and South Vietnam. Apollo 18 dock in orbit, da, da, da. The FSLN overthrows Somoza and armed uprising following year. Soviet Union invades Afghanistan. Dr. Emmerich becomes a father. Uh-huh. In 1980, he names his son Hal. The United Nations establishes the University for Peace in Costa Rica. 1980, that happens. Costa Rican president, blah, 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 Gorbachev, blah, blah, blah. All I care about is Hal, I guess. Berlin Wall falls, Costa Rican government persuades Panama
big
to abolish. The big boss triggers the outer heaven uprising.
I guess that's Metal Gear 1.
Holy shit.
Damn.
We didn't see that last time.
We did not.
2005, Miller is found.
Oh my god. No. Oh shit. I knew that had to have happened, but holy shit. Oh my god. That's fucked up. No. Ocelot, man, why'd you do that?
Was it Ocelot?
No, Liquid.
Was it Liquid?
Why'd you do that, man?
Was it Liquid or was it Ocelot?
Well, it was Liquid.
Liquid knew about it.
Liquid was pretending to be him.
Fuck.
What the fuck? That's fucking mean.
Dude.
Dude, that's fucking...
Dude.
Wait, the end was here? What?
What?
Yeah, there was a thousand of credits for the end.
What? What? Dude.
I really like that ending.
That was a great fucking ending.
I really like that whole thing where it just ties into, like...
Fucking yes.
It ties into so many other things.
Solid one.
It ties into... It, like, shows so, like, going to Solid 4 with PMCs and stuff.
Yes, that's fucking amazing.
And you can see it going into Solid or Metal Gear 1 with, like,
that,
the whole,
I hate,
like,
that it all came at the secret ending.
I know.
Though, like,
that's...
I mean, like, I'm gonna be honest. That ending and the boss fight kind of made it worthwhile for me. Like, that was...
Yeah! That, we spent this whole...
It was horrible going through all of that to get to
it
this
was
end.
Way harder than it needed to be. It was... Yeah. We spent an entire day, basically, getting the ending.
Yes, this was completely insane and unnecessary, but...
We do have a new codec.
What?
I mean, not a codec. Well, I mean, like, a little ending talk.
Oh.
Like,
do
it's
we?
A secret.
I hope, always, I really dude, fucking hope
there's
so.
There's a secret ending! There's a secret codec after the secret credits!
Wait, so 2005, that's...
Yeah, that's about
Metal
Gear Solid.
Is that when Metal Gear Solid 1 happens?
Yeah, it's around that time.
Okay, so 1995, that's gotta be when
Metal Gear
Solid,
1
or Metal Gear 1.
Or 1 or 2, or 2, I don't know. Huh?
I think Big Boss is the...
He's the boss in Metal Gear 1,
Metal Gear 1, yeah, and he's, I think... Sorry, spoiler alert, if you haven't played Metal Gear 1 by now, it was released 40 fucking years ago.
I know!
But yeah, Big Boss is the bad guy in Metal Gear 1, and he's like also the bad guy again in Metal Gear 2.
I think so.
Yeah. It's
funny. In Metal Gear 2, you destroy Outer Haven, I think, as Solid Snake.
Yeah. So, wait a minute.
All of this is
wait
shit
a minute.
Go
wait,
boom.
Wait.
By
okay,
Solid Snake.
Okay, okay,
so mean.
I can't say something that I know about a certain game that we're gonna play very soon. So I'm like, but
codec sequence.
But
it's
that
gonna happen. It's gonna happen.
But the thing.
It's gonna happen right now.
But the thing
Randy,
that
it's
I
gonna
saw.
Happen.
But what we played before on
Randy,
my
it's gonna
computer
happen right
in my
now.
Room,
we're about to find out.
But the thing.
Oh my god.
That we
god,
played
this
on
game.
The ground.
Dude, I just. I don't know why, but I like those endings where it's like super fucked up. Like, it's just not a good ending for like them. It's like,
it was a blow your mind ending because it mentioned things that you're like, I get what that is, even though they're not saying it.
And you already played the other game, so you know like this ends horribly for Big Boss.
Yeah. Well, does it really?
Oh, kinda.
I mean, in Metal Gear 2, he's like, this Outer Heaven's gone.
But then, he goes into hiding or whatever for, like, 20 years. It's Solid 4.
What year does Solid 4 take place, do you know?
2010, maybe, somewhere around there.
Yeah, I don't think it's very long. Like, I know it's not long
maybe,
enough.
Maybe it's, 2020, something like that. Maybe, like, 10 or 15 years after Solid 2.
I think, I want it probably 10, I would guess. Just totally guessing.
Yeah.
Well, wait a minute. 2005 is when Solid 1 takes place. 2002, like...
Snake looks way older in Solid 2.
I think only a couple of 3 years passes.
Really?
Maybe. I think it was like about 3 years pass since the events of Solid 1. And then...
I'm pretty sure Raiden, like, coma something something Solid 2 to Solid 4.
Yeah, like, he's... Something gets really fucked up. Or they, like, do... Like tests on him or something?
I don't know.
Experiments
I don't
or something? Know. Something weird. And he gets his blood replaced with milk.
But yeah, like we find out Zero's behind Cypher and Big Boss eventually captures Zero in his old man form.
He does?
Yeah, the Solid 4. Remember?
Oh, that's right, yeah, that's true.
Yeah.
What when? What the fuck did Cecile have to do with any of the story?
Nothing.
Wow. Okay.
That's like asking what did Sigint have to do with anything. Nothing.
Well, that's racist. It's racist of you to just say that.
What did Paramedic
that?
Have
what
to...
are you saying?
What did Paramedic have to do with anything?
It's also racist of you to say that Mei Ling had nothing to do with this. Very racist.
Oh my god.
Okay, yeah, this story was fucking amazing. It should not have been that hard to get to the amazingness.
This game would have just... This... Kojima... What are you doing, man? You fumbled. You fumbled, man. You
fumbled with the... All
just,
this...
This game...
With having him run away 7 fucking times.
Like, just most of this game, though, was just like...
You know
didn't
what?
Didn't even matter.
Honestly, now that I think about it, like... Him running away 7 times was just to, like... Distract everyone... So that Paz could go and, like, reprogram Zeke or something like that. So that she could control it.
Yeah.
But, like, yeah, it took 7 missions, but it didn't have to. You could have justified that with, like, 3.
You
could have
gotten
3.
The point across, with 3 or whatever.
And you didn't need to put fucking 3 missions in between each fucking one that you made us do. That was unnecessary.
We got the cool music, though.
Oh my god, please be another...
I know, oh my god, I'll turn on my freaking volume.
If there is another thing, I'm gonna pee on this couch. I will urinate
All right, let's go.
Please, Kojima.
Oh, oh God. Here we go.
Oh, shut up. Wind. Is your audio good?
Yeah.
Okay.
I don't hear anything.
Footsteps.
We will forsake our countries. We will leave our motherlands behind us and become one with this earth. We have no nation, no philosophy, no ideology. We go where we're needed, fighting not for country, not for government, but for ourselves. We need no reason to fight. We fight because we are needed. We will be the deterrent for those with no other recourse. We are soldiers without borders, our purpose defined by the era we live in. We will sometimes have to sell ourselves and services. If the times demand it, we'll be revolutionaries, criminals, terrorists.
Oh my God.
Yes, we may all be headed straight to hell. But what better place for us than this? It is our only home, our heaven, and our hell. This is outer heaven.
Damn!
That was madness. That was
pretty awesome.
Setting up so hard for fucking Metal Gear 1.
And Ground Zeroes, because that takes place before 1.
Yes.
And Phantom Pain as well.
New co-ops. I can't read right now. I don't care about anything anymore. I beat the game. I saw the ending. I heard the monologue. I don't care. I
could stealth just, gun design.
I don't care. I don't care about
Are
this.
We done? Like, is that it? Is that this game?
I would think so. I think like, that's it.
Did we just finish the game?
I think we just finished the game.
I guess we just finished the game. Because it doesn't take us to the main menu or anything.
No.
I got horse. Thanks. Or hose. No, I got hose.
You got multiple hose? I didn't get hose.
Wow.
Oh, the music is cooler. Yeah.
Let me look at the
The final auto assign for the staff.
I know, forever.
Never. Okay, guys, you're witnessing right now. These people will never do anything in their lives. These people are destined to forever wait in the waiting room. They will never join a squad or anything. I will never, almost certainly never ever play this game again. I'm gonna be honest, I will never play this again. I don't have any desire to play this.
33 missions.
Wait. 33 missions?
Yeah.
33 total?
Yeah.
So the internet was not lying. Yes. I honestly... Okay. Think about all the Metal Gear games that... Well, you joined me halfway through Solid 2. You joined me through Solid 3, Solid 4, and now Peace Walker.
Yep.
Which games would you not play again?
This one.
This
one.
Any other ones? Would you just... You just don't have any desire to play anymore. Ever.
Solid 2, maybe?
I would say...
Yeah, Solid 2, like, just nothing about it makes me want to experience it more than 2 times.
Yeah.
Because I've already experienced it once before.
My list is a little bit bigger. My list includes this game. We didn't record Portable Ops, but I don't have any desire to play that again.
No.
Solid 2. I don't feel like playing Solid 2 again, ever.
Are you gonna move Solid 3?
Maybe Solid 3, maybe. It's just really long. It's just really long, and I don't know if I want to sit through all of that by myself again. I don't know. I'm not sure about that. You know, I'm gonna say Solid 3. It's just really fucking long. It's just really goddamn long. I don't think I could have gone through that game alone, honestly.
We played this game for 24 hours.
You know what makes Solid 4 easier to swallow than Solid 3 for me is that it feels more like segmented. So I can kind of play it in like little bursts and like, you know.
Yeah.
Like Solid 3 is like you go to one area and then you go to another area.
Solid 3
and
is
then
just,
there's a boss fight.
Solid 3 is more just kind of like one big like three massive areas.
Yeah.
And Solid 4 is more like here's this one really big area, but then you got a lot of cutscenes at the end, and then you go to another really big area.
Yeah. It's kind of like why I think a game like Call of Duty is so popular, just because the games are so friggin' short.
Yeah.
You can just jump in, play for like a match or two, and then just turn it off, and then you don't need to invest fucking hours of your life.
I don't think
in
I would
Dota game.
I don't think I would ever play Solid 4 anymore.
Yeah, I think
Solid 5 is just the game I'm going to go to experience the Metal Gear gameplay.
The Metal Gear way of the Metal Gear lifestyle.
Just the gameplay of Metal Gear. And then, like, it's been a long time since I played 1. So
I would like to play Solid 1 again. At some point in my life, I would like to again. Now that I've fucking seen all this shit, I would like to go back with all this shit I've got in my brain and just be like, oh my god.
Yeah.
You're the guy that is that guy in that other game. But yeah, Solid. I really liked Solid 1 a lot. I don't know why exactly. Like,
It has a good story.
Yeah.
You're freaking crazy evil twin brother and shit.
Yeah, and then there's betrayal, and then there's crazy shit, and then there's so much conspiracies.
Yeah.
So many conspiracies. I can't speak English because I've been in Costa Rica too long. Yeah, Nicaragua.
But yeah, like, I can't see myself playing Metal Gear Solid 4 anymore because I already played it twice.
Yeah, yeah.
Once with no alerts and no kills. And then I...
No, well, 2.5 times, I guess.
Yeah, I mean, then I experienced it again on this channel.
Yeah. So, like, I mean, you did it first normally, second, no alerts because you're a psychopath.
And no kills.
Do you still have that save data?
Probably.
On his PS3 that has not been turned on in years? And, on this channel. But honestly, I don't know. Solid 4, the controls and everything are so good. I might, maybe, possibly, years, decades from now, might want to play it again.
Yeah.
Solid 1, I would definitely like to play again at some point.
Yeah.
This game, never again. But pretty much, it's just this. Solid 1, definitely. Solid 4, maybe. Everything else. Solid 3, maybe, also. Yeah. I'll throw that in there. Solid 2, no.
Metal Gear 1, huh?
I don't care about writing. You know what? Honestly, I don't know if I have the patience to deal with Metal Gear 1.
No, right, I've played it, no.
Or Metal Gear 2.
No, no. It's like, it's the first Legend of Zelda, basically, where
exactly,
you got...
That's exactly what I was going to compare it to.
Where you just got to, like, know exactly which screens to go to.
Where you have to know exactly which spot on a random wall to place a bomb.
Yeah.
To fucking find an old guy
and
to
which
give...
key card to equip for each door.
Well, I think those are numbered in Solid... Wait... No, okay, never mind.
You literally have to equip every key card to find out which opens the door. It's pretty ridiculous.
Did it just reset?
No, because you didn't touch the controller.
No, my PVR just reset.
Well, that's not
good. Oh my god.
Well, it
doesn't matter. Hang on, you know... Oh.
It does matter.
You know what? Hang on. It completely doesn't matter because if the... Hang on. Let me stop the recording and we'll get back because we're in the middle of stuff. Okay, so... At the very end, that was kind of crazy timing that would have just happened. I don't know if it was just because I hadn't touched the controller in a while, or...
I don't know. PVR reset, it was weird.
Yeah, my recording device basically reset, and the screen went black for a second. That usually fucks up the recording, or usually just stops the recording, but it kept going. I don't know.
Yeah.
Whatever. So you guys are not seeing Metal Gear anymore, you're seeing a blank screen, or my logo, or something,
yes.
I don't know. A picture of me on my couch. I don't know, with coffee on.
Yeah,
but anyway, I kind of want to listen to the music still.
I love this series story, man. It's just love the series so much. Oh my god.
You know, like, I do really like it too, honestly. Like, I remember so long ago when I decided, like a madman, on my old YouTube channel, Wild Wolf G, which is horribly named.
Yes.
That I wanted to play every Metal Gear game. And I knew all, like, I had never played a Metal Gear game aside from Solid 4 and Portable Ops on PSP.
It's so fucked up because we both played through Solid 4 basically through the end and then played the other rest.
I know, like, I didn't know. I mean, you know what? It's kind of good though, because when I played Solid 4, I didn't know what the fuck was happening. Yeah. And that's kind of a good thing, because I got to go experience all the other ones, and I didn't feel like I was spoiled by Solid 4.
Yeah.
I mean, like, I know...
Solid 4 is just kind of so in the future. Like,
yeah.
Really, the only thing it spoils is, like, Solid 1-ish
yeah,
stuff.
All I pretty much knew at the end of Solid 4...
was that Liquid and Ocelot were just, like, going weird shit.
Yeah, like...
doing weird shit.
There was a Liquid Ocelot...
hybrid.
Fusion... they did a fusion dance, and I vaguely remembered an old guy named Zero. I didn't know who he was or what he did, but he was just there, and he was old and in a wheelchair, and he'd shit himself at some point or peed himself. I don't know.
I experienced this story so fucking weird. Like, I think the first Metal Gear game was 3, and then I almost beat that.
You played Solid 3 before Solid 4?
Maybe.
Did you?
I remember being in a place where, like...
wait, when the one you bought for PS2?
Yeah.
Oh,
I remember. I might have played Metal Gear Solid 4 first, but then I was like, I got to the end of Metal Gear Solid 3. I'm like, wait a minute. I should play the rest of these games first. Like, I was right before the Shagglehod. And then
you stopped?
No, I beat the game. I beat Metal Gear Solid 3 and then I experienced the rest.
Solid 1, then Solid 2?
And then Solid 4 again.
Hmm.
And I didn't play Solid 3 after that.
That's kind of good, I guess. I mean, like...
it was such a weird, like...
yeah.
I experienced, like, the very last game of the series at the fucking first. So fucking weird.
But I guess it's kind of good that you played Solid 3 first, just because Solid 1 and Solid 2, like, have a lot in common. And Solid 3 is so far behind those, chronologically.
There is a lot of stuff that, like, I definitely see kind of why Kojima made Solid 3, like, a prequel game out of nowhere. After playing Solid 1 and Solid 2, like, this legendary big boss that you hear about all the time and stuff, and, like, yeah, that would be pretty awesome to play as him, like, after playing the first two games.
Yeah. Yeah, especially after Metal Gear 1 and 2 had established such weirdness between
them.
I mean, like, I really like the story a lot, but I do see... okay, the PPRV just fucking restarted again. Not that it matters, because I stopped recording. I see kind of what Kojima does to just add a new Metal Gear game. He, like... at the very end of a Metal Gear game, he adds some cryptic extra secret layer of something that you didn't know. And it's pretty much just like, well, you thought Ocelot was this guy? No, he wasn't. He was actually on their side. Like, and it got so crazy at the end of Solid 3. Ocelot was basically triple crossing. And me and Sarah tried to figure out what the fuck that even meant.
Yeah, pretty much.
A triple cross is pretty much just like a cross. Isn't that how it works?
I don't know. I don't want to go back into that.
Numbers, I don't know. But, like, it's kind of like with Peace Walker. How he came up with Peace Walker was he had Metal Gear Solid 3 and he had Metal Gear Solid 1. He put Peace Walker in between. Well, actually, he had Portable Ops, too.
Yeah.
After Solid 3.
Yeah. Portable Ops was like the predecessor to Peace Walker in terms of Mother Base recruiting stuff.
So pretty much he knew that, like, okay, at the end of Solid 3, Snake is a good guy.
Yeah.
At the end of Portable Ops, Snake is still a good guy. Pretty much, yeah, he's a good guy. And he knew that, okay, at some point...
Snake has to be the bad guy.
Yeah, because...
thanks to this fucking MSX computer release.
So he had to figure out how he would make that transformation...
I mean, we're seeing the transformation now.
Yeah, I mean, he's not like evil, really.
I can start to see it now, though.
Yeah. Especially with that last fucking
cutscene.
Yeah.
We're going to hell, guys.
Yeah, like we're like selling ourselves. He's basically like, who fucking cares about anything else, man?
Fuck countries and borders. We are a nation without borders, and we're going to hell because this is outer heaven and hell.
But yeah, like, with... In Ground Zeroes, it starts to further that plot point.
Yeah.
And in Phantom Pain.
Really want to see how the fuck Phantom Pain ends.
Oh my god.
I want that so bad. But one thing I'm kind of concerned about, I'm really concerned about, actually.
The fact that it's an open world?
No. The fact that Kojima... The Phantom Pain, I don't know if it's... I guess it's got to be finished by now, but Kojima left before it was finished, right?
I think he's still working. I don't know.
But like,
I'm pretty sure he left as it finished.
Konami,
there's no way he
Konami
left.
Konami does not want the Metal Gear Solid series to end, right?
No,
they want to continue it without Kojima.
Well, I mean, just look at Castlevania. Oh. It's never end. It's never Pachinko, pull the lever.
What I'm saying is like. Konami wants to do this without Kojima.
Yes.
That sounds horrible to me.
This Metal Gear Solid 5, to me, almost is guaranteed going to be the last Metal Gear game. The last true game.
I kind of hope so, but I
No,
don't.
I mean, like, that. Like, there's going to be more, and I'm probably not going to accept them as canon, because fuck that.
You know what I would honestly really think, and I think I might have said this at the end of Solid 4, is that, like, I'm kind of expecting another... Metal Gear spinoff. Not Metal Gear. Not Metal Gear Solid. Fuck Rising. That's not even a game. I don't acknowledge that it exists. Metal Gear something. And it's basically the same...
Combat.
It's basically this. It's basically espionage and action and tactics.
I'm pretty sure that's what's going to happen. Because it's basically going to turn into Star Wars. Where, like, George Lucas had his run... And then afterwards, like 20 years in the future or whatever.
I don't know about Star Wars, man. I'm not a giant, massive Star Wars fan, really.
All I know is that original trilogy.
The first one fucking sucks. The episode 4 is garbage. I don't care what anybody fucking says. Princess Leia just ruins the movie with her fucking moodiness and her bitching. No. Episode 5 is good. I haven't seen episode 6 in a long time. But anyway, getting back to Metal Gear. Konami is going to continue with Metal Gear, if they're going to do another Metal Gear Solid and try to get somebody to write a story within Kojima's massive, enormous story framework that he's created over decades, I don't think it's going to be good.
You don't go anywhere from Metal Gear Solid. Like, you don't.
You know what? You could, though.
Solid Snake was going to become... The only way they go anywhere with this is if they pull a Splinter Cell and they just keep being like, this was my last mission, but they keep pulling me back. That's the only way. If they go full Splinter Cell where, like, literally every game, Sam Fisher is like, that was my last mission, but now... They have my daughter or whatever.
Yeah, that's...
That's the only way.
That's the danger of basically giving a happy ending to your game. Like, Solid 4
wasn't really a happy ending, though.
It kind of was.
Because Snake was like... Just like, he's just like gonna live his life out in
peace. Yeah, it was like a peaceful ending, I guess.
I mean, he's still kind of fucked with Autocut. Wait.
Was he gonna die still, like super early?
Wait, I kind of remember just Otacon saying something like, "Wherever you go, I'll follow you."
You know what? You're right.
No.
I think in the end of Solid 4, it was like Snake was like, "Well, I don't have long."
Well, I don't have long left to live, Otacon. You shouldn't be here because it's gonna be dead. It's super depressing. And then Otacon was like, "Well, I like you, Snake. We're bestest friends. I'll follow you to the end because we've been together since Metal Gear Solid 1 when you saw me pee myself."
Yeah, like,
so that was pretty much the end. Solid Snake was going to die soon. Otacon is his buddy. He's going to stick with him.
The only way I guess I can see it happening is Sunny. One last mission where Snake is about to die and just Solid 6. After Solid 4, because fuck you, Kojima.
Yeah, if there's gonna be a Metal Gear Solid after Solid 4, it would have to be like Snake's final fucking days, and then you would probably see him die at the end of the game or something crazy. But I don't know if they would want to do another game with old Snake.
I don't know.
I think it would be too crazy for them to be like, well, what actually, been cool, we found a cure for Fox Die.
I think what would have been, all right would have been kind of like another PMC kind of game-ish, but with Johnny or something, if he didn't marry Meryl.
Yeah, Johnny is just dead to me. what I think could be amazing.
That would have been the other main character to me.
What I think could be amazing or horrible, one of the two, is Metal Gear Sunny.
Oh, no.
Metal Gear
Sunny. Please, no.
I mean, that's just... She's Olga's daughter, though, who was the ninja chick.
Oh, my God. No, don't give them ideas. They're listening.
Konami,
Stop it.
I got ideas. I got Word documents.
No.
I have diagrams.
Like, I just... I
have flowcharts.
I haven't played the last Halo games, but, like, a lot of people just consider Halo 3 just to be the last one, or ODST, or whatever.
The other ones, like, prequels or something?
No, they're sequels. So Halo 5 is... No, Halo 4 is a sequel.
Is there a Halo 5?
Yeah, there's, like, gonna be another trilogy with Master Chief still.
What the I've only ever played Halo 1.
Yeah, like, Master Chief and Cortana are still a thing.
Are they, like, in love or something?
No, I mean, but they're still alive.
Oh. I just knew that, sorry, spoilers for Halo 1, but Cortana is like, betrays you at one point, I think.
Something like that.
You're in a big circular place, and she's like, actually, I'm a bitch, and you're gonna die. And then you kill waves of enemies and escape a place.
Yeah.
And then you backtrack every level that you've been to, but it's just colored differently. That was stupid.
Yeah. Anyways, just Konami, please don't fuck it up.
Yeah, so...
Please give it to a competent development studio.
I don't think that they would or could do that. I don't think that they would.
I don't know.
I don't know. I would like there to... You know what I want? You know, here's what I want to do. I want Kojima Inafune to create...
Kojima Inafune!
Mighty Number Solid.
Solid Number 9!
Yes, Solid Number 9. I want him to create Solid Number 9, and I want it to be amazing.
Oh,
I don't know about Mighty Number 9.
I don't know about it. My faith has been abolished.
There's voice acting in it, which sickens me. Just sickens me. There should not be a
voice. Well, there's voice acting in Mega Man Legends, isn't there?
Yeah, there is, but that was fine because Keiji Inafune did it. But it's just... I don't want that. I want an old-school Mega Man type game. Give me that. I preferred old Zelda games when Link never talked. Yeah. He didn't say anything, and you just hear the sword swish. Yeah. He doesn't go... every time you fucking... But anyway, back to my old point that I did not finish about Kojima making new Metal Gear games. All he needs to do, really, is to just...
Kojima.
Well... What he did with Peace Walker, I think.
Oh, it's okay, just okay.
Pick an empty space in the timeline.
Yeah, that's pretty, yeah.
And just figure out, okay, End of Solid 3, Naked Snake is a good guy. Portable Ops, under Portable Ops, he's still a good guy. But at some point, Solid 1, or Metal Gear 1, sorry, Naked Snake, a Big Boss, is a bad guy. Yeah. Or he is perceived as a bad guy. It kind of seems like he was just kind of misunderstood the whole time, or he made mistakes.
Yeah, maybe.
Yeah, at the end of Solid 4, he was like, you know, if I fucked up, I am going to die, and I'm old, and you're going to die, and we fucked up because we're snakes or something. The world doesn't need snakes or something shitty.
Yeah.
But he seemed
The darkness or the shadows or whatever the fuck.
He seemed to be not as evil as Solid Snake thought he was.
Yeah, pretty.
I kind of really would have liked it if there were another Metal Gear game in which Solid Snake and Naked Snake were kind of together. Like a solid... It couldn't happen now because Solid 4 kind of sealed that.
Yeah, like, you know. There's just... The only... Like, it just wouldn't... It wouldn't make any sense at all in the timeline.
Yeah.
If they try to, like, put it between, like, Metal Gear 1 and Solid 1 or something.
Yeah.
It wouldn't make sense.
Because it kind of seemed like that was the first time Solid Snake, like, ever saw Naked Snake.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure he thought he died or something.
Outside of Solid 1 and... Or outside of Metal Gear 1 and 2. Yeah. Yeah, well, he also thought he died at the end of Metal Gear 1. The end of Metal Gear 2.
Yeah,
he was like, nope. Nope, I had one HP left. You didn't see.
Yeah.
I had an energy tank. But anyway, like, so pretty much all you need to do... Plus, you know what? I think, thinking back to Metal Gear Solid 1, there's a lot of backstory. A lot of backstory for, like, almost every character. And, like, all the bad guys pretty much have, like, backstories. Their own individual backstory. Solid Snake kind of has... Doesn't actually have that much backstory.
No, not really.
But, like, yeah, if they ever mention some... Or fucking, the ninja...
Cyborg Ninja?
Yeah, he had backstories.
Because he was in Solid 2. He was in Solid 2, so... I mean, not Solid 2. Metal Gear 2. So, like, yeah.
But I mean, like...
Well, they had to, like, fill the gap, like, I guess,
what I'm wondering is, like, did they ever mention something that happened, quote-unquote, in the past that actually hasn't been in a previous game? Like, if in Solid 5, could they, like, just say something about fucking Ocelot was in the something war? He fought in the something war that we'd never heard of. That actually had...
They probably said it in Solid 3.
Like, that's a way to set up for the next game. If just to give yourself a vague idea, like...
Wait, no, Solid 3 happened before, whoops.
Yeah, like in Solid 5, it just gets revealed that Ocelot was in the something battle or the something war. The something conflict.
Yeah.
The something conflict that was never mentioned before. But wait a minute. The next game is all about the something conflict. That's exactly what Peace Walker did. Peace Walker set up MSF for Metal Gear Solid 5. It seems like this was just a little stepping stone for Solid 5. Like, Kojima was like, all right, we wrapped up Metal Gear 4. We got Metal Gear Solid 3. We got portable ops that nobody bought. So, but there's something missing in between Portable Ops and what I want to do with Metal Gear Solid 5, Ground Zeroes and Phantom Pain. So, I'm going to make another game. I'm going to call it Peace Walker. And it's going to bridge the gap between Portable Ops and Solid 5. Because I'm pretty sure, it seems, I would imagine Kojima had an idea for what Solid 5 was going to be.
Like, the thing is, too, like, this game also, like, with this game's ending... Like, there didn't really need to be a Solid 5. Like, this game ended, like, really, like... This, like, it looked like it would just kind of be, like, the end of his story arc that we see.
Yeah.
Like, that looks like a pretty good end to me.
Yeah, like, yeah, you're right. I mean, it sets up Snake to be a bad guy.
Yeah.
I guess we're going to see that transformation in Solid 5. But if it already sets it up, we know it's going to happen in Metal Gear 1. So, yeah, there really isn't a need for Solid 5. But maybe... Solid 5 opens the door.
I'm just Sam of Solid 5. I'm glad he's making it.
But what makes me concerned about the end of Solid 5, and I'm just completely speculating. I haven't read up on this. I'm theory crafting.
Yes.
I'm a theory crafter right now. Is that Kojima... Things between Konami and Kojima went bad sometime during the development of Metal Gear Solid 5.
Yeah.
So... I'm sure that must have some kind of influence on how he wanted to end Solid 5. Either end it the way he ended Solid 4, clean cut ending, nothing else.
Yeah.
No crazy codec ending, nothing, there's no fucking Ocelots like, hey, Mr. President, I fucking was lying the entire time. Or he's gonna be like, fucking Campbell... We know about the twin snakes, the project, true. And the
Les Enfants Terribles project.
Like, I don't think...
I don't know.
Because Kojima knows that he would not be involved in the next one, I don't think... Well, I mean, that's the thing, like, as the writer, if you're going to add in some crazy shit at the end to lead up into the next game, and but you know you're not going to have anything to do with the next game. It's going to be a completely different writer. And there might not even be a next game.
Yeah.
Why would you end it to lead up into something else? So I'm thinking...
Like, the thing is, like, with all... Like, Kojima... There's so many interviews, like, after every game, basically. Kojima's saying, like, yeah, his last one. And, like, it just feels like every time he says that... But he always says it with the fucking codec sequence.
Did he say that for Solid 1, 2, and 3?
I think he said that for 1, 2, and 3.
That's insane if he did, because he left the crazy shit at the end.
Yeah.
There was no crazy shit at the end of Solid 4. I really thought that was it.
Wasn't there crazy shit in Solid 4?
At the very end Kodak thing?
Yeah, wasn't there?
No, it was just Snake kind of alone with Otacon.
Oh.
And Otacon was like, fucking, I'm going to be with you till the end. And Snake was like, I'm going to die soon. You should leave. And so Otacon's like, no, we're friends.
I know he said that for Solid 2. For sure.
Solid 2, there was some crazy shit about the president. No, Solid 1 ended with something about the president.
And Solid 2 kind of wrapped up that story arc.
Yeah. What was the end thing in Solid 2? It was...
I think it was a triple cross.
No, that was Solid 3.
Otacon
was like, I triple cross.
Ocelot.
Whatever.
I don't remember.
Ocelot.
It might have been Ocelot had the... He knew about the Philosopher's Legacy or something. Something with Philosopher's Legacy. Pretty sure.
Ocelot was in Solid 2, right?
Yeah. I mean, well, Liquid Ocelot.
Yeah. I don't remember what...
I think it had to do with the Philosopher's Legacy.
Solid 2 is very blurry to me.
Yeah.
I really didn't understand a lot of that shit about GW and whatever the fuck.
Memes.
That went way... Memes... That all went way over my head.
He said a lot of times that, like, yeah, it's the end.
Yeah.
It's.
I mean, so, yeah, what I'm expecting at the end of Solid 5 is a clean cut. No more Metal Gear Solid
I would love it if he did, like, a crazy ending that led into Solid 2 or, like, Solid 2 or Solid 4. Like, not even Solid 1 or some crazy shit or not even Metal Gear 1.
Well, it would have to be Metal Gear Solid 1.
Just
if
like
anything.
Some crazy thing that like connects it to a game that like you didn't even expect it to connect to or something.
I really like that this game referenced Solid 4.
Yeah.
Solid 3 heavily because it takes place after it, but even Solid 1 a little bit, did it? I don't know. I don't know about that one. I mean, well, at the end the timeline did.
Yeah.
That was cool. I really wanted to know what the fuck happened to Miller. That sucks, man. He gets assassinated.
Damn.
It's cool. He has cool sunglasses.
I know.
Fucked up. So yeah, what I'm expecting is no anything after Solid 5.
No.
I'm expecting that to be the end.
I expect Kojima or Konami to make a pachinko machine with Snake's face.
A Snake pachinko machine.
And I will be disgusted.
Yeah, I don't know.
I can't wait to play it. Oh my god.
I do want to see the end of it, but I know how it must have to end.
Yeah, everyone has
Wait a minute.
Huh.
Wait a minute. I'm thinking about the end of this game.
Yeah.
Something is completely missing from this game.
Yes.
Do you know?
Yes.
What it is?
Yes.
A character?
Yes.
A little character?
Yes, Randy. I know exactly. There's two things that happen right in Ground Zeroes that like just kind of come out of fucking nowhere.
I kind of see one of the two.
Yeah.
One of the two things.
Yes.
One of the two things.
I see
one of them absolutely headed in that way. But the other one? No. Where does that happen?
I don't know. I don't fucking know, man.
Where does that...
I don't know, man.
What the fuck?
It has to be explained in Solid... Well, okay. We get cassette tapes in Ground Zeroes that we never listened to that explain some backstory between this game...
Do we get cassette tapes?
Yes, Randy, we do. Yes, we do.
Of a torture?
Yes, we do.
Of a torture?
Yes, we do.
Do we get to listen to it?
We can.
Can we touch ourselves? No.
And it will be ridiculous. Stuff's going to happen in Ground Zero soon. It's going to be amazing.
Yeah,
oh my god.
So me and Sort of play Ground Zeroes. I know what the fuck happens at the end of Ground Zeroes.
Yeah.
I'm thinking about this and the end of Ground Zeroes and one little thing does not add up.
Yep.
I don't know what the fuck, but it's madness. But yeah, I guess we'll... Do you know how much time elapses between this and Ground Zeroes?
No.
I kind of want to know that. I guess I'll
We'll probably find out in like one of the cassette tapes, audio recordings or something.
I kind of want
to... Because there's a lot of them.
I kind of sort of want to look that. You know what I think I want to? Oh my god.
We might just find out in the game.
I think what I want to do is before we start playing Ground Zero is I'd want to make a very loose, non-detailed little timeline.
Oh my god.
Not even of major events. Just games. This game took place this year. Just so we see how much time elapses. Yeah.
Probably YouTube videos for that stuff.
And I also want to watch and have somebody on YouTube explain to me what the fuck Metal Gear 1 and 2 is, because I still never... I don't know what the fuck goes on in those games.
Big Boss, bad guy. You kill Big Boss.
I know there's a Big Boss and he's evil, and then there's a Frank Yeager or something.
Yep.
There's a Gray Fox or something.
Yep.
And he's a ninja.
Wait a minute. What is... Something about Fox was mentioned being created in this game, right?
I think it was the ending timeline.
Fox is evil in Solid 1.
They are?
Foxhound or something. One of the foxes. They're evil, aren't they?
Okay, Fox and Foxhound. So, Foxhound is hunting Fox?
I think it's the other way around.
Fox hunts Fox? No, because a fox... Wait, what the fuck is a foxhound? It's a dog. So, it would be a dog meant for hunting foxes, I would guess.
I guess.
So, okay. So they're going after the members of Fox. Solid Snake is a member of Foxhound, right?
I think so.
Naked Snake.
Isn't Meryl also a Foxhound or something? Wait, no.
She's Campbell's daughter, who I think later joins Foxhound or something.
Probably.
The Diamond Hounds.
And then there's Fox Die.
It is kind of crazy now that I think about it that, I mean, this is a very minor spoiler, but at some point in Metal Gear Solid 5, I mean, it's all over the trailers. If you don't know this, then you're retarded. Yeah. If you've seen the trailers, but at some point,
just skip this.
Naked Snake, like renames MSF to like the Diamond Dogs.
Yeah,
that isn't mentioned anywhere in any other movie.
I don't know, man.
As far as I know,
I don't know, man.
Never heard of Diamond Dogs.
I think I know why, though. So,
do you know why?
I think I do.
I don't know.
But it's a spoiler.
Does it? Do you
for
know?
Ground? Well, we'll find out Ground Zeroes, I think.
Okay. I think I see it too.
Yeah. All right.
But I'm just kind of wondering why that.
Yeah, it's
like it's kind of crazy for Kojima to just throw that in there.
Yeah.
In a game that's in the past.
Yeah.
And
where
no
you
other
just kind of have to like fit everything, just kind of make everything fit.
Yeah.
It's like nah, just fuck it.
Like I guess he just. Well, I mean, Naked Snake. Well, actually, come to think of it, Naked Snake.
Venom Snake.
Naked Snake really isn't talked about a whole lot in Metal Gear Solid 1, 2, and 4, is he?
No, not really. I mean,
like, hardly at all. He's actually just called Big Boss.
Yeah.
He's not even called Naked Snake in that one.
Naked Snake is his code name for the, like, Virtuous Project or Virtuous Mission.
Yeah.
Whatever it's called.
Yeah, so there's a lot of shit.
Yep.
About Metal Gear.
Yep.
And I need to learn more of it, and I need to edit a shitload of videos.
But that's this game.
Yep. It is. Yep.
That's this game.
That is Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. I feel like the more Metal Gear Solid games I play, the more I have to say because it's just cumulative.
There's just too many.
It's like a snowball.
There's just the web grows thicker.
It's a giant snowball of snakes.
The web grows more complex. Game's fucking weird.
It's insane. It's amazing and it's insane. Kojima's a madman and I hope he makes something else that's
I wanna buy whatever he makes next.
I do. Yes. Okay, so that's fucking you have anything else do you want to add? Because this is the end.
Can't wait for Ground Zeroes.
Phantom Pain. Okay, so not that it really matters much for me to say this, but I need to edit these videos, and I'm gonna upload them very fast, way faster than I have been.
You'll already know this. As the finale video goes up, you already see like 50 videos.
Chances are, if you're watching this, then you've probably seen us play Ground Zeroes or Phantom Pain.
Yeah.
Because I imagine that's where all my subscribers are going to come from.
Probably.
I got a lot from Dead Space 3, and this is fucking Metal Gear Solid 5.
Yeah.
Alright, so that's it for fucking Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. We did everything except for all the extra shit that doesn't matter. We fucking spent an extra 4 fucking hours to get to the end, and it was amazing. And I'm kind of glad that we did it.
Alright,
that's Metal Gear Solid Peace Walker. We'll see you guys later. at ground zeros.
With an S.
Yes. Later.